Before I share my opinion of Apex Legends, I want to clarify that this is the first Battle Royale game I've spent a lot of hours in. Before I picked up this game, I played Fortnite once at a friend's house and I played a few matches of Apex Legends at another friend's house. But it took me till 2020 to get a Battle Royale game for my own gaming console. I chose Apex Legends because it appealed to me more, since it plays almost the same as Titanfall 2, a game that I absolutely love. This is no surprise, as it's made by the same developers, Respawn Entertainment. Since I have almost no experience in the Battle Royale genre, I will be unable to compare Apex Legends with its competitors such as Fortnite, Call of Duty Warzone and PUBG. So don't expect any comparisons in this video. Now with all of that out of the way, let's see if this game is as fun to play as Titanfall 2. I'm sure everybody watching this video knows how the Battle Royale mode works, but for those who don't, it's simple. You airdrop from a flying ship to land at the preferred location. Pick up armor and items, kill enemies, move towards the safe ring as the ring closes, and survive until you're the last one standing. The premise is simple and everybody can pick up the game and play, but it also requires skill and map knowledge to increase your chances of winning a match. And no match is the same, as some can last 2 minutes while others can take up to 20 minutes. Hopping into a match is a matter of seconds, so if you die right after landing, it doesn't take long to begin a new match. There are also rarely any moments where I had lag or framerate drops, which is a good thing since every action means life or death when facing an opponent. All of this combined makes for a very addictive gameplay loop, where you keep telling yourself to play just one more match, and before you know it, you've put another hour in the game. So Respawn Entertainment has done an excellent job in creating a highly replayable Battle Royale shooter. Now let's take a closer look at the maps of Apex Legends.
My abilities aren't working.
Apex Legends has two Battle Royale maps, World's Edge and King's Canyon. Each map is made up of smaller areas. There are large buildings, small villages, deserts, hills, railroads and many more unique areas in both maps. And a care package with valuable loot is occasionally dropped in the arena. And let's not forget the jump tower and ziplines. Great additions that make it easier to traverse from one location to the next, especially when the ring is closing. With all of these additions, the two maps are not just horizontal and bland, but are instead horizontal, vertical and engaging, as most teams will be fighting to get to the high ground and gain an advantage over their opponents. I personally like World's Edge more because I find the areas in that map more interesting and better designed. Once you've become familiar with both maps, you as Jumpmaster can decide at what area you and your teammates will be landing. Everyone has their favorite places, but there are always those areas that a lot of teams drop at, resulting in very chaotic first minutes if you decide to go there. In terms of movement, Apex Legends controls better smooth, and with the vertical map design, you can also slide down hills to either close the distance with your opponents, or more easily outrun enemy gunfire than if you were to run. But if your only option is running, you can hold triangle to unequip your weapon and run faster, which can mean life or death if you're caught outside of the ring. The only thing missing from Titanfall 2 is the wall running mechanic, which was definitely one of my favorite mechanics from that game. But I don't miss it that much in Apex Legends, and the hill sliding more than makes up for it. Inventory management is easy and straightforward. You don't need to manually equip attachments to your weapons, this is done automatically. And if you pick up another weapon, all your equipped attachments will be carried over to your newly picked up weapon, if they are compatible. This makes the first few minutes of every match where you're picking up everything you can get your hands on a lot less tedious, as you don't have to manually equip all of your newly looted items. Most weapons in Apex Legends are pulled straight from Titanfall 2, which might not be as original, but these weapons are incredible, so it doesn't bother me that much. There are assault rifles, submachine guns, light machine guns, sniper rifles, shotguns and pistols. Aside from your weapon classes, the weapons also differ in ammunition they need. You might assume all assault rifles use the same ammunition type, but you'd be wrong. Some weapons use light ammo, others heavy, sniper, energy ammo or shotgun shells. Ammunition is differentiated by color, so if you see ammo laying on the ground, you immediately know if it's the ammunition type you need or not. The same goes for the level of equipment and armor, giving visible colors of white, blue, purple and gold to indicate their level. During a match, each weapon can be upgraded by equipping various attachments such as extended mag, barrel stabilizer, weapon stock and scope. My favorite weapon to use is definitely the M600 Spitfire LMG. Whenever I spot this weapon, I will immediately pick it up. The second weapon I like to use, usually in combination with the Spitfire, is the longbow, the newly added Volt SMG, R301 carbine, or the EVA 8 auto shotgun. During a match, it's also possible to come across fully kitted legendary weapons or supply drop weapons that can be found in care packages. Aside from your firearms, you also have deadly frag grenades, termite grenades and arc stars at your disposal. If you've taken damage, you can regenerate your body or evo shield using shield cells and batteries. To restore your health, there are syringes and medkits. And the all-powerful Phoenix kit restores all of your health and shield, but it takes 10 seconds to charge, during which you are totally vulnerable. So you always have to make sure no enemies have you in their line of sight. If you do get spotted by an enemy and he downs you, you can still protect yourself using knockdown shields. And with a golden knockdown shield, you're even able to revive yourself. Ultimate Accelerant restores 35% ultimate energy, and with the mobile respawn beacon, you're able to deploy a respawn beacon at your position. All of these items take up space in your inventory, but luckily there are plenty of backpacks you can equip to increase your inventory size. All these items can be found on the map, with the rare ones like the Phoenix kit appearing in smaller quantities.
I took care of it, don't worry.
Since this is a battle royale game, the story hardly matters. Yes, there is a small story revolving around each season, expanding the lore, but I really don't care, even when it's set in the same universe as Titanfall. For me though, it's all about the gameplay. But if you're interested in the lore, you can read pages to get a better understanding of the universe and characters. I will say though that all legends are instantly recognizable and likable, with my favorite being Pathfinder in that regard.
Maybe? I'm the Jump Master. I won't let you down, except by falling.
With the addition of Season 6, Apex Legends now has a total of 14 legends, though I've only played with the first 9 legends, with my favorite being Lifeline, Bloodhound, Caustic and Pathfinder. Legends are categorized into classes: offensive, defensive, support and recon legends. Each legend has a passive, tactical and an ultimate ability. Wraith, for instance, has a passive ability that can detect danger, a tactical ability that lets her travel to the void, keeping her safe from gunfire for a few seconds, and her ultimate ability lets her link two locations with portals. Another legend, Mirage, has a passive ability that makes him invincible whenever he revives a teammate or uses a respawn beacon. His tactical ability allows him to send out a holographic decoy. And with his ultimate ability, Mirage can create a team of controllable decoys. These are just two legends as an example, but as you can see, each legend has unique abilities that differentiate them from the other legends. No legend is overpowered or underpowered, resulting in a fair and balanced game. Legends can complement each other perfectly, making for great teams with a high chance of winning. To communicate with your teammates, Respawn Entertainment have added a ping system. The ping system is a genius addition to the Battle Royale genre, as you can inform your teammates of enemy location, certain items or what your next action will be. Before landing, you can also use the ping system to suggest a drop location. This works incredibly well if your teammates also actively use the system, though there were just a few occasions where I had teammates that never used it, resulting in a puzzling match where I was never sure what my teammate would do and if they would have my back in case we encountered enemy teams. And with no surprise, whenever I had a team like that, I never won a match. But those are just rare moments, and most players will use the ping system. And even though I have never played a match with my friends, only playing with strangers, I still had a lot of fun. I can only imagine how fun it must be to play Apex Legends with friends. If you are not a team player, the downside of Apex Legends is the fact that you can't get into a match on your own. The minimum requirement is a team of 2, with the most popular option being a team of 3 players. If a teammate dies, it's possible to pick up his or her banner and respawn them at respawn beacons, which stimulates players to stay in the game and not leave as soon as they've died. I had a few instances where I died but was revived and we made it all the way to the final 2 teams, so so don't leave the match and assume all chances of victory are lost. Teams that work together will win more games than a team with players minding their own business instead of working together. So far, 6 seasons have been introduced since the original release of the game. Aside from adding one legend each season also adds slight variations to gameplay, with Season 6 adding crafting to the Battle Royale game. This makes Apex Legends worth playing, and prevents it from getting stale. So if you only played Apex Legends during Season 1 and 2, it might be worth playing again, just to see what's changed since then. Since this is a free game and is published by EA, Apex Legends has microtransactions. Luckily, these are only cosmetic. You can either pay or grind for weapon skins, legend skins, voice lines, finishing moves and banners. Or you can grind or pay for loot boxes with a rare chance of obtaining these items. I never paid for these, as they feel more rewarding to get by playing the game instead of paying for them. Though unfortunately, new legends are only unlockable by spending 12,000 legend tokens, which takes forever, or by paying for them. But since it's a free-to-play game, you could pay for them as a thank you for the hard work Respawn Entertainment has put in the game. So I can accept the cosmetic microtransactions, and even though I don't agree with the way legends are unlocked, I can understand it as they want to make money. However, I still wish they would have been unlocked by something like completing challenges or leveling up. In terms of graphics, Apex Legends is certainly not the best looking PS4 game, but is still pleasing to look at. And for me, the performance is more important than the graphics. The soundtrack was composed by Stephen Barton, who also created the music for Titanfall 1 and 2. The soundtrack for Apex Legends has a total of 5 tracks. It only plays at the main menu, when picking a character, when dropping, and when you win a match. So it won't distract you during a match. The soundtrack is a nice addition to make the moments when you're not playing a Battle Royale match less boring, but I won't be listening to the soundtrack when I'm not playing the game. It achieves what it needs to do, but nothing more than that. In conclusion, Apex Legends is a kick-ass game. The more I think about Apex Legends, the more I want to start up my PlayStation 4 and play another match. I've spent tens of hours in this game already, but I just can't get enough. There is something that Respawn Entertainment does so perfectly that makes it so addictive to play. With EA as the publisher, there's always that slight chance that their greedy hands ruin the gaming experience. But luckily with Apex Legends, this is not the case. It's without a doubt a must-play game, especially since it's free. Even if you're not a huge Battle Royale fan like me, just give it a shot. You might end up liking it as much as I did.
Down an enemy.